WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange is in a London court fighting his extradition from the UK to Sweden. Stockholm wants him on accusations of sexual wrongdoing, something Assange denies and says the accusations are politically motivated. RT's Laura Amit is outside the court for us and we join her live now for more. Well, Laura, Assange's defense has braced itself for a tough battle, so it seems, hasn't it?
It has. This is due to be a two-day hearing. It's only just started. It was due to start at 10 o'clock this morning, and we saw Julian Assange himself arriving at court at around 9 o'clock to prepare for that. So this is just day one. And as you say, he is wanted for questioning in Sweden over allegations of rape, molestation and unlawful coercion. Those were made by two women in August over in Sweden. And Julian Assange himself has always said that these allegations are politically motivated, that these women were somehow either paid or forced to make these allegations against him to bring him down, essentially. We don't know what the prosecution's going to be arguing at the moment, but unusually, the full defence argument is being released on the website of Assange's lawyers. We know the preliminary arguments. They're going to say that his human rights could be violated if he was extradited to Sweden and on then to the US, which is what the defence lawyers are saying that's going to happen. They say that there's a risk, a big risk, that the US will seek his extradition or even illegal rendition to the US after he's been deported to Sweden, and that there's a real risk then of him being detained either in Guantanamo Bay or in some kind of similar facility. They're also going to argue that he would be at risk of the death penalty if he was sent to America. And they're also fighting on grounds that he hasn't actually been charged with a crime. And one of the principles of extraditing people is that you can't extradite people just if you suspect that they've done something. You actually have to charge them with a crime. You can't just send people to other countries in order to question them. Now, the death penalty argument is key because if they manage to successfully argue that Assange might be subject to the death penalty, an EU country cannot extradite to a jurisdiction where a suspect would face the death penalty. So that really would be the end of this extradition argument. But we have to wait quite a long time, we think, to see what exactly is going to happen.
Yes, indeed, Laura. Well, let's take a look at all possible scenarios there. And how likely is it that Assange will be sent to the States?
Well, we know that the Swedish prosecutor's office has come out and said that Assange, even if he was extradited to Sweden from here, would be protected by strict EU rules, and that in fact Sweden wouldn't be able to do just whatever it liked with Assange once he got there. Sweden would have to get approval from the UK to then agree to another extradition request from another country, in this case the United States. They also say that politicians are not involved in the legal process. And so this would be a decision that was made by the court in Sweden whether to extradite him to the US. So there wouldn't be any involvement from politicians. But as we are saying today, many say that Sweden's friendship with the US has got quite a cozy, close friendship with the US, may mean that Julian Assange's extradition is much more likely. My colleague Anissa Nawe filed a report on just that. Let's hear what it says.
Sweden, a quiet little neutral Scandinavian nation.
The current foreign policy establishment in Sweden has a remarkably close relationship with the United States.
The country that gave us ABBA, flat pack furniture, $4 meatballs, top models, and blonde bombshells may not be so neutral after all. American influence is everywhere, from food to feature films, but in Sweden, it seems to be supersized.
Just the other day, the Deer Hunter film was shown again on Swedish TV for the 60th time. It's an awful film. It's the worst propaganda.
Politics through the back door, like Sweden's ties with NATO.
You have the military and some politicians cooperating intensively with the United States and with NATO, and the large mass of the population being totally unaware of all this stuff going on.
But it's not just what Swedes aren't taking in. It's also what their leaders are ready to give.
From Julian Assange to terror suspects to NATO support, when America wants something, they get it. But why? And what's in it for this so-called neutral nation?
They get all the benefits of being an intelligence partner of the United States without the baggage of being in NATO.
It's a partnership decades in the making.
There's been a willingness to do the errands of the United States over many years, from questions of making asylum seekers in Sweden available to the CIA, but is particularly strong now with a right-leaning government in Sweden.
And with the U.S. wanting him for spying and Sweden wanting him for sex crimes, Julian Assange is wanted by quite a team.
And the Assange WikiLeaks case seems to be just a continuation of this very old intelligence relationship.
Here's some other relationships we dug up. Julian Assange ticks off the U.S. with fierce reaction from one of the country's most notorious neocons.
This is not a particularly credible source in my mind. He's a criminal, and he ought to be hunted down and grabbed and put on trial for what he has done here.
These words from Karl Rove, who claims he's part Swedish and just happens to be advising the country's PM, while the former Swedish Minister of Justice is a partner in the firm who filed charges against Assange for sex crimes. With another link to the U.S., Thomas Bodström is claimed to have handed the CIA asylum seekers from Sweden who were then tortured.
The questions about neutrality became even clearer thanks to some of the documents from exactly WikiLeaks.
And if the UK can secure asylum for Boris Berezovsky and Ahmed Zakayev, both wanted for serious crimes in Russia, it could be argued there's enough room in the British justice system to protect Julian Assange from the United States of Swedemerica and let him keep blowing his whistle. Anissa Nawe, RT, Stockholm, Sweden.